Shalom Aleichem and welcome to Online Smicha. Many people ask, whatever happened to the 10 tribes, the Aseres HaShvatim? Many people want to know where they are today. I can't get into that. I don't know where they are exactly. I don't think anybody really knows. But what caused them to get lost amongst other nations? So this is actually, believe it or not, it's a Gemara in Masechta Shabbos. The 22nd Perek Masechta Shabbos, Daf Kuf Mem Zayin Amid Beis. The Gemara says like this, a very fascinating statement with a tremendous lesson. Amar Rab Chelboy said, Chamra de Frugisa, the wine from the place called Frugisa, Umaya de Yomses, and water from this special river, Kipchu Aseres HaShvatim Yisrael. That's what made the 10 tribes fall away. Why? The special wine was very, very tasty and very, very luxurious. And the fun and the pride and the luxury you got from bathing in this water and in this river really caused a tremendous connection to Gashmius. So the Aseres HaShvatim, this is what the Gemara says, were so into their Gashmius of drinking wine and bathing and benefiting from the water, this special water, that's what kicked them out. They got lost. And the Gemara goes on to say a story with a tremendous message. Rabbi Elazar ben Aruch, ikla lehem. Rabbi Elazar ben Aruch, the great Rabbi Elazar ben Aruch. Rabbi Elazar ben Aruch was one of the greatest giants of the time. He went to these two places to drink some of the wine and have some of the luxuries. And when he got too involved with these items, Ikar Talmude, he forgot everything he learned. Kihadar Asa, when he came back to where he originated from, Kam Lemikre Besifra, and he started reading a Sefer Torah. He wanted to read the Sefer Torah. Baal in Mikra, he wanted to read the Sefer Torah, and he came to a pasuk in Parshas Shemais, in Parshas Boy. The pasuk says, "Hachodesh hazeh lachem reish chadashim." This chodesh, the chodesh Nisan, would be the first reish chodesh. The words "Hachodesh hazeh lachem," he read "Hacheresh haya libam," which means that you were mute, your hearts were stuffed, your hearts were closed. He, instead of reading HaChodesh, he read HaChodesh. Instead of reading Hazeh, he said Hoya. And instead of reading Lachem, it was Libam. He lost the simple letters of the Aleph base. He couldn't, because the great Rabbi Elazar ben Aruch got so caught up with the luxuries of Olam Hazeh that he lost it. Bo Rabbon Rachmelda, the Chachamim asked and prayed on his behalf. V'hoder Talmudein, and he got back whatever he lost. And the Gemara goes on to say, V'hainu d'tnan, this is what the Mishnah says in Pirkei Avos, the great Rav Neiroi says, Have a goylal memkoim Torah, always be in a place of Torah. V'al toimar shi'itavi acharecha, don't think it's going to come following you. Shekein chaveirecha yikaimu biyotcha. That's the Lashon of the Mishnah. Now this story actually in Medrash Kehelas, it's actually brought in more detail. And the story said, Rabbi Elazar ben Aruch was one of the great Talmidim of Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, right about the end of the time of Bayis Sheni. And he was probably one of the greatest Talmidim of Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai. When Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai passed away, the students went traveling to Yavne, and in Yavne they established the big yeshiva of Yavne. Rabbi Elazar did not go with them. He said, "You guys, you Rabbonim, Dayonim, Tzadikim, stay in Yavne. I'll go somewhere else." He went to a place called Amus. Why did he go to that city? Because that's where his wife was from, and he settled right next to a water, a lake, an ocean. A place where it was beautiful sights. That's where he settled. And he waited for his chaverim to come join him. Look, I have a gashmi, it's a luxurious life. When they did not come to join him, he wanted to go back with his friends, to move back to his friends. His wife, once she has such a good life, Begashmius, didn't want to move with him. He says, it's not nice that you should go chasing them. Wait for them to come to you. The bottom line was, says the Medrash, the friend stayed in Yavna, the friend stayed in the place where it was a Matan Torah, and Rabbi Eliezer ended up staying with his wife in the place where the luxurious Gashmius life. And living there, he forgot everything he learned. And the Gemara and Avos de Rav Nosson comes to a conclusion, and he says that because of how he became so involved with the Gashmius, that's what made him lose all his Torah, and that's why the Gemara continues and says, Rav Nairoi, I'm a heavy guy, l'mikta'im Torah. The only way to really acquire Torah is if you're in a surrounding of Torah. And I want to conclude at this topic. There's an earlier Gemara, a beautiful earlier Gemara. The Gemara in Daf Kuf Yud Ches. In Daf Kuf Yud Ches, the Gemara says, Amar Rabbi Yossi says, Yehei Chelki, I hope that my part in Olam Haba should be amongst those who are Mimoshivei Beis Medrash, those who are announcing and getting the people to come into Shul. Into yeshiva. And not those who give the clap on the table, say, Seder is over. Those who are the first one to leave and make everybody leave, I don't want to be one of those. I want to be the ones who are calling more and more people to be involved in Torah learning.